Hi everyone, welcome back to the Laravel 7 tutorial. In this video, we are going to learn about Blade templates. Blade is the inbuilt templating engine for Laravel framework. Blade is a very powerful and easy to use templating engine that makes writing syntax very easy and readable. Blade templating engine comes with its own control structure such as conditional statement and loops. It is very easy to create a Blade template. Simply create your view file and save it with the .blade.php file extension. Alright, Blade templates are typically stored in the views directory inside the resource folder. Okay, so now let's create Blade template file. So go to the project and inside the project, just click on resource folder. So first of all, close this folder and just click on resources folder. Inside the resources folder, just click on views. And here just right click and just click on new file and let's say file name is test.blade.php. Alright, a Blade template file is now created here. Inside this Blade file, I am going to type here a message like inside the h1 tag. Just I am going to write here test blade. Okay, now for access this blade view, we will have to create a route. So go to the web.php file and just click on web.php and here on the bottom just write here route colon colon get, let's say URI is test. Alright, and just write here callback function. Alright, and just return here. Sorry, return view. Okay, and view name is test. So inside the view, just pass here test. Alright. Now save the file and let's check. So go to the browser and in the URL just type here localhost colon 8000 slash test. Okay, you can see here this message test blade. Okay, this text is coming from test blade file. Okay, now let's see how we can create a variable inside the blade template file. So go to the testblade.php file and inside this file I am just going to write here create here a variable. For that we use @php directive for typing php code inside the blade template. So just write here @php and @endphp. Okay, inside this directive just to define a variable, let's say variable name is name. So just write here $name is equal to and just assign the value. Let's say value name is Jennifer. Alright, now print this name variable value using double curly bracket. So here I am just type here inside the h3 tag, let's say hi, or and inside the double curly bracket just write here $name. Okay, now save the file and let's see in the browser. So go to the browser and just refresh the page. You can see here at Jennifer. Now let's see the if statement. So first create go to the test.blade.php file and here I'm just going to create here array. So just write here fruits is equal to array and inside the array create some element, let's say mango, apple, orange. Alright, now use this array inside the if statement. So I am just write here @ If count just inside the count method, just pass here the array dollar fruits. Okay. If count fruits, count of fruits is equal to 1, then just write here, not in this way, just write here single fruit. Okay, otherwise, and at the rate else part, else if count of dollar fruits is greater than 1, then just print a message more than 1 fruit. Alright, and at the else part, else no fruit. Right, just close the if statement to at the rate in if. Okay, this is the syntax of if directive. Okay, now let's check it the browser. So go to the browser and just refresh the page. You can see here more than one fruits. All right, and if I remove two fruits from here and just save the file, you can see just refresh the page, you can see here single fruit. And if I remove all element from here, just save the file and refresh the page, you can see here no fruits. Okay, now let's see the loop in blade template. So let's see at the rate for directive first. So go to the test.blade.php file and here just write at the rate for dollar I is equal to, let's say, 1, dollar I is less than and equal to 10, dollar I plus plus. All right, at the rate in the for. And inside this for directive, just write here in the double curly bracket dollar I and also break br type. Okay, now just refresh the page. You can see here 1 to 10. Okay, numbers. Now let's see at the rate for each directive. So for understanding at the rate for each directive, just add here the some element inside the array. So just write here apple, mango, and let's say orange. Okay, now display each element from the array using at the rate for each directive. So just type here at the rate for each and just write here dollar fruits edge dollar fruit. All right, and inside the for each directive, just write here, just print here the fruit. So inside the double curly bracket dollar fruit. Okay, and break the line with br tag. Save the file and let's check the result. So just go to the browser and refresh the page. You can see here the element apple, mango, orange. Okay, all right, now let's see ternary operator. For understanding ternary operator, just create a variable here inside the at the rate php directory. Just create at the rate, sorry, dollar is equal to let's say assigned with 18, Now let's use the variable inside the ternary operator. So just write here inside the double curly bracket dollar is greater than 18 question mark. Just print here you are an adult. Okay, otherwise just print here you are not adult. All right, now save the file and just refresh the page. You can see here you are not adult. Okay, if yes is greater than, just write here the equal. Okay, save the file and just refresh the page. You can see here you are an adult. If I change the age, let's say 17 or 16, and save the file and refresh the page, now you can see here you are not adult. Okay, Blade template engine provides include directory for including a view inside another view. The child view will have all the variables that are variable to present view, parent view. For understanding include directive, just add another view. So go to the project and inside the view folder, just create a new file. Let's say file name is headers.blade.php. Alright. Now put some text here. So I'm just right here inside the h1 tag. Let's say this is header. Alright. Now add this view to the test blade. So just go to the test.blade.php file and here on the top, just write here include and just pass here the view name, which is headers. Alright, now save the file and let's check. So go to the browser and refresh the page. You can see here this is header. Okay, so in this way you can use Blade template in Laravel. So that's all about Blade template. So thanks for watching this video, and if you still have any kind of question, you can ask me in the comment box. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.